Okay, so today I'm going to teach you a very interesting chapter. That the name of the chapter is The Snake and the Mirror. Okay, The Snake and the Mirror. Clear? So the snake and the mirror, that is a very beautiful chapter. What are the basically main characters of this chapter? Main characters of this chapter is narrator, okay, and snake. Basically, narrator is narrating a story about a homeopathic doctor. Narrator is telling a story about a homeopathic doctor. Okay, so what happens with the homeopathic doctor? Okay, he was living alone. What happened in his room? So homeopathic doctor is telling about all his story to a narrator. So this whole of the chapter is given in the form of narrating in narrative. Because narrator who is telling about the story, he is narrating the whole story about a homeopathy. And another character of this chapter is snake. Okay. So I'm going to start, but before starting this chapter, I want to ask you some question, and you have to tell me honestly. You have to answer me honestly about those questions. Only then you can enjoy the beauty of this chapter, The Snake and the Mirror. Okay. So get ready for that. So get ready for that. The Snake and the Mirror. Tell me, screen is visible to you. See, this chapter is full of humor. You are going to laugh a lot. If you are completely engrossed in this chapter, if you are completely absorbed yourself in this chapter. But first of all, just do one experiment. I want to tell you, all of you go and watch in mirror for 1 minute. Go. I'm giving you 1 minute break. Just go and watch in mirror. Go. In camera, you can also see it is just like a mirror. But you in your house, wherever there is a mirror, just go and see. There is one experiment that I'm going to do it with you, because I don't want to teach you in a very boring method. And you also involve with me. You also participate in that activity. Only then you are going to enjoy this chapter. Now tell me. You all have seen your image in mirror. After looking at yourself, then come back and sit on your seat in front of laptop. Now tell me honestly, who have seen themselves in mirror? Tell me, how many of you have seen themselves in mirror? Tell me honestly, because I want to see that how many students are participating in class and how are they enjoying chapter. Tell me honestly. I have given you a very simple activity. Just go and watch in mirror. It can be in washroom, it can be you can see and after yourself come back. You all have seen yourself? Okay, how many of you have seen? Let me see. Let me see how many students are obedient. Dhiren, Mitansh, Akhilesh, Jasleen, Sudiksha, Ashmeet, Kirti. Okay, only these
ones.
Others are sitting still idle. I have given them very simple activity. So, why I have done this experiment? You know why? Because I want to make you realize this thing. Because if you will do this activity, only then you can enjoy the beauty of the chapter. Because in this chapter, basically, it is given that when a person looks his image in mirror, first of all, though, there is no one who doesn't like to see himself in mirror. Do you come in that category who doesn't want to watch themselves in mirror? Do you come in that category? everybody loves to watch themselves in mirror. Okay, so when you watch yourself in mirror, so many thoughts occur in your mind. Okay, so many thoughts occur in your mind. Are you agree or not? When you see yourself in mirror, so what do you think? Some students are doing annotation. So what do you think? Thoughts come in your mind or not? Yes, tell me. Thoughts come in your mind or not? Yes. When you see in the mirror, so what do you think? Some think that they are so good looking. Some think, no, they are not good looking. Some think, no, I should do some work on my looks. Okay. Some think, yes, no, today I'm not looking so good. Some think, no, I'm the cutest person in the world. Okay. Some think, no, there is some, you can say, drawbacks, and I should work on those drawbacks. Every person has their own perspective when they look into the mirror. But suppose there is a mirror in your room, can you stop yourself without looking at that mirror? Can you stop yourself? Suppose if there is mirror in your room, can you stop yourself without looking at your the mirror? I think no, not at all. Not at all. There was one fake ID I have removed and reported. So what happens basically, whenever you look yourself in mirror, you can't first of all stop yourself looking into the mirror, and whenever you look into the mirror, so many thoughts come in your mind. Okay, so this is all about that chapter. Okay, suppose all of you have seen yourself in the mirror, what kind of thoughts were coming in your mind? Do you think to look at yourself in the mirror? What do you think about at such time? Have you ever seen a dog, a cat, or a bird look into a mirror? What do you think it sees? It means when you look yourself in the mirror, what kind of thoughts come in your mind? Type in chat box. I'm going to read. When you look at yourself in the mirror, what kind of thoughts? So I want to share one thing with you. See, there are so many good personalities. When they get up, when they get ready in the morning, and when they look themselves in the mirror, so what do they do? They think, yes, it is the best day. I'm going to make it as a best day. I'm going to walk the world, and I'm going to do something different, something positive in my life. And this is a commitment to me. So if you start your day with this thought, I think your day can be the best. Don't you think so? I have read it somewhere that good personalities, successful people, when they look themselves in the mirror, so they talk to them, and in this way they boost up their confidence. Okay, Renuka is written how I am looking. Okay, Divya has written, sometimes we feel like beautiful, but sometimes I insecure. Okay, it happens. But we should not, you can say, so much be worried for our looks. I think so. Okay. And it is a tip that I have read it somewhere. When you look into the mirror in the morning after getting ready, you should see, you should say to yourself, you should talk to yourself that, yes, I'm going to make this a special day. Okay. So every person has their own perspective. When they look into the mirror, everybody thinks different. But you tell me, when any of the animal, when they look into the mirror, how do they think? They think about their looks or not? do you think that they think about their looks? Do you think? No, not at all. Type in your chat box. Type in chat box that animals, they don't think about their look. They don't know. They are not aware of this thing. Yes, Aparan has written a very good line. They think that there is someone another like them looking at them. Yes, who is standing in front of them? He looks like me. Yes, so animals can look like, think like that. Renuka, Divya, yes, Laksh, all are writing so well. Yes, so when animals look into the mirror, so they think that there is someone who are like them. Okay, now you just read about this humorous story, full of fun. You are going to enjoy it thoroughly. And this story is about a doctor, about a snake, about a mirror. Okay, so who is going to read first? First page, who is going to read? Afterwards, I'll be telling you the meanings and... Okay, Ashmeet Kaur. Ashmeet, okay, you start reading.
Has a snake ever coiled itself round any part of your body? A full-blooded cobra? All of us felt silent. The question came from the home path. The topic came up when we were discussing snakes. We listened attentively as the doctor continued with his tale. It was a hot summer night, about 10 o'clock. I had my meal at the restaurant and returned to my room. I heard a noise from above as I opened the door. The sound was a familiar one. One could say that the rats and I shared the room. I took out my box of matches and lighted the kerosene lamp on the table.
Now see, in this chapter, there is one homeopathic doctor, okay? But this homeopathic doctor is not so rich, okay? He is a very ordinary person. He is not rich. He is very much poor. And he is telling about his story to a narrator. And narrator has written about this story. So here, homeopathic doctor, when he is telling about this story to a narrator, so the first question he asks that, suppose you think that there is a cobra and he coiled himself around your neck. Okay, full-blooded cobra that is very much strong. So what will happen? Suppose if I ask this question from you, that if any cobra comes and it coiled around your neck, what will be your reaction? What will be your reaction? Tell me. What will be your reaction? Type in chat box. Aparan is written. Aparan has written. It's haunting. It is so terrible. Nobody can. Yes, it would be terrified. Yes, Ashmeet, very good. Aparan, very good. So this situation would be very much, you can say, horrified situation, very much terrified. It is very much difficult to handle this situation. So such kind of question was asked by one of the homeopathic doctor to narrator and all his friends. So there was a pin drop silence after listening to that question. So this topic was discussed when they were discussing about snakes. So when homeopathic doctor asked them this question, so the doctor continued with his tale. Continued with his tale means he continued with his story. And what story was told by homeopathic doctor? Listen to that story very, very carefully. What was that story? That basically it was a hot summer night. Near about 10 o'clock was the time. Okay, and he took his meal at a restaurant. When one of the child was reading this, she spoke restaurant. It is wrong. Its correct pronunciation is restaurant. All of you try to speak this pronunciation. It is restaurant. All of you unmute yourself and speak. Restaurant. Okay, so it was basically a hot summer day. He took his meal from a restaurant. He came back. And from above, he was listening different kind of sound, okay? But this sound was familiar one. Why it was familiar one? Familiar means he was used to listen such kind of sound. Why so? Because this sound was of rats. Because the place where homeopathic doctor was living, in that place, there were already so many rats. So he was used to listen such kind of noise that in his place he was always listening the sound of noise. Okay. So he took out his box of matches and after that he lit kerosene lamp and this kerosene lamp was kept on the table. See, there was no electricity also in their hut. In his house, there was no electricity. He had to survive only with the kerosene lamp during night. Okay. Because the house was not electrified at all. Electrified means no electricity connection. It was a very small room, rented room where he was living on rent. It was not his own room. He was paying a rent and living in that room. And he was doing only a medical practice there. And his earnings were very much meager. What is the meaning of meager? All of you write down. His earnings were very much meager. So, bachche, write down the meaning. Meager. Meager means very small. Okay, write down the meaning of meager. Okay. So, his earning was very much meager. What meager? It means he was earning only 60 rupees. He was having only 60 rupees in his suitcase at that time. And in his suitcase, there were only some shirts, dhotis, and he was having only, he possessed one solitary. What is the meaning of solitary? Solitary means only one. Okay. He was having only one black coat. And at that time, he was wearing that black coat. Okay. And he only possessed. Possessed means having. Okay. So he was having only that thing with him. Okay. So this was his condition. His condition is described like that, that he was living in a very small rented room. His salary was, his income was very much less. Meager means very much less. And there was no electricity. He was on a practice. So such kind of physical infrastructure is given in the chapter. And the room where he was living, this room was already having so many rats. So there was a lot of disturbance. Okay. Now, third paragraph, who is going to read third paragraph? Okay, Dhiren, you read third paragraph.
Yes, ma'am. Amit, my voice coming?
Yes, yes. Speak third paragraph. Read third
paragraph. Okay, ma'am. I took off my black coat, white shirt and not so white vest and hung them up. I opened the two windows in the room. It was an outer room with one wall facing the open yard. It had a tiled roof with long supporting gables and rested on the beam over the wall. There was no ceiling. There was a regular traffic of rats to and from the beam. I made my bed and pulled it close to the wall. I lay down but I could not sleep. I got up and went out to the veranda for a little air, but the wind got seemed to have taken time off.
Okay, now try to understand the meaning of third paragraph, what is written by narrator. So, he was having only one black coat and he came after taking dinner from a restaurant and when he came back, he took off his black coat. He was wearing black shirt, he took off that white shirt. And not so white. What is the meaning of that? Not so white. What can be the meaning of that? Can anybody tell me? What is the meaning of not so white? Not so white. Tell me. Not so white means very much dirty. Not so white. So he also not so white vest. Vest, you can say inner wear. Okay. So, and hung them up. He hung them up at one side. And there was no electricity. It was very much difficult because it was a hot season. It was a hot summer day. It was very much difficult to survive there without electricity. So, that's why in order to take air, he opened the window. And it was an outer room. There was a one wall. And this wall was facing open yard. and there was tiled roof and there was gables. What is the meaning of gables? Gables, you can see in the picture it is given. Here it is gable. Here it is given gable. So this is basically a gable. So what is gable? Gable is upper part of a wall below a sloping roof. So the it is a physical infrastructure that is given in the chapter, that where a room, a hut where he is living. It was very ordinary hut where he is living, and there was tiled roof. Okay, and these roof were given support with gables, you can see in the picture, and there was a one beam. On that beam, support was given with the help of beam, and there was no ceiling at all in this, in that room. Okay, clear? Have you written the meaning of that? And there was a regular traffic of rats to and from the beam. What is the meaning of traffic here? Traffic means so many rats were coming and going. So many rats were available in that hut. So that's why he has, with a lots of humor, he has used a word traffic here. Traffic here means so many rats here were coming and going. He was habitual of that. And from where those rats were coming and going, there was a beam. So from that beam, that support was given in that hut. So from that beam, so many rats were coming and going. Okay. So after that, he made his bed. It means he made his bed. Meaning he spread a bed sheet. He kept his bed covers and all the things on a bed. And he pulled that bed very much close to the wall. It means his bed was having a very light weight. So that's why he could pull it so easily. He was lying down there, but he was not able to sleep. Why he was not able to sleep? Because it was a hot summer season. There was no electricity. There were so many rats in the room. It was a very small room. Air was not coming in that room. So that's why he was not feeling sleepy at all. And in order to sleep, whatever he did, he got up and he went to the veranda. So that, why did he went to the veranda? So that he could enjoy, he could have a, you can say, sigh of relief by having a little air, because he was feeling so suffocated in that place without air, without electricity. Okay, so he went into that room, but the wind god seemed to have taken time off. What is the meaning of taken time off? Can anybody tell me what is the meaning of taken time off? Taken time off. What is the meaning of that? Taken time off, it means the god was on leave. Taken time off mean, it means there was no air. There was no breeze. There was no air. It means the wind god seemed to have taken time off. It means wind god was on leave. It means no air was blowing. It was not blowing at all. Breeze was not blowing, and it was completely hot summer season. Clear, bachche? So write down the meaning of taken time off. There was no air or breeze at all. Clear? So you write down the meaning side by side, only then you'll be able to understand the chapter. Clear? Now let's proceed to paragraph number 4th. Who is going to read paragraph number 4th? Who is going to read paragraph number 4th? Okay, Mitansh, you read 4th para.
Ma'am, I don't have a book right now.
You can read from the screen.
Okay. Can I start now?
Yes, yes.
I went back into the room and sat down on the chair. I opened the box beneath the table and took not a book, out a book, the materia medico. I opened it at the table on which stood the lamp and a large mirror. A small combi lay beside the mirror. One feels tempted to look into a mirror when it is near one. I took a look. In those days, I was a great admirer of beauty, and I believed in making myself look handsome. I was unmarried and I was a doctor. I felt I had to make my presence felt. I picked up the comb and ran it through my hair and adjusted the parting so that it looked straight and neat. Again, I heard the sound from above.
Okay. One thing the more I want to tell my student, whenever reading is going on the class, you all should have the books. Next time I will not spare my students, those who will not have book. I can call any of the child to show me the book on the screen and show me the meanings they have written or not. Okay. Beta, you have to write down the meanings only, then you'll be able to understand the beauty of the chapter. So now this, I really love this paragraph. You completely engross yourself in this paragraph. You are going to laugh a lot because it is a fact and you will enjoy it. So what happened? There was no air. It was very much difficult to survive in such kind of temperature. So he went back into the room, and what did he do there? There he was sitting on a chair, and when he was sitting on a chair, he opened the box, and what was there in the box beneath the table? What is the meaning of beneath? Beneath means under. Write down the meaning of beneath. Beneath means under. Actually, write down meaning side by side. So beneath means under. So under the table, okay, there was, he took a book, and the name of the book was Materia Medica. That was a book that a doctor used to read because he was doing a practice there. So he used to read such kind of medical related books. So he opened, when he opened it at the table, and there was a lamp, there was a large mirror, and beside a mirror there was a small comb which was kept beside the mirror. Okay, so when there was a mirror in front of him, there was a comb, would he stop himself without looking into a mirror? I have done one experiment with you now, and I have told you, suppose there is a mirror in your room. Would you be able to stop yourself without looking at the mirror? No, not at all. It is a fact. So that's why I have told you to do this experiment. So when he was absolutely free at that time, he was not able to sleep. He was not feeling sleepy at all. So when there was a mirror, he started looking himself into the mirror. So when he had only take a look, single look at a glance, he looked himself in the mirror. So he started looking at the mirror, and he thought he was such an admirer of his beauty. It means he really loved himself. He really loved his look. And he said, he thought that he should look more. He was thinking that he was so handsome. And at that time, he was unmarried also. Moreover, he was a doctor. So he thought that he should work something on his look so that his presence can be felt. What is the meaning of this line, that his presence can be felt? It means whenever he was looking himself in the mirror, so he thought that he should work upon his look. He should improve his looks so that whenever he sits among, you can say with his friends or among any person, other person, so his presence can be felt because he wanted to look very much handsome. So what did he do? He took a comb, he started making his hair, okay, and he was adjusting his hair through the parting. Parting, you can see the partition of the hair from that is done, okay, and his parting was looking so straight, and he thought that his parting should look so straight, it should look so neat. And when he was completely absorbed in the mirror, he was looking at the mirror, he forgot about the rats, he forgot about the hot summer season. He forgot about this thing that he was not feeling sleepy. No air was there, no breeze was there. He was feeling so suffocated there. And it was a very, you can say, useless day for him because he was not feeling sleepy at all. But when he looked himself into the mirror, he forgot about all his worries. He was completely absorbed in that, and he was thinking and thinking only about his looks. Okay, so this is all about this. Up to 4 paragraph we have gone through this chapter. Rest of the chapter we will be continuing tomorrow, and I hope my student will also read these 4 paragraphs again. And if you face any kind of difficulty, if any of the word meaning is not clear, if any of the line explanation is not clear, you can ask me tomorrow. Now time is running out, my dear students. I have to over this class. Okay, and we will continue this chapter tomorrow. By the time you go through these 4 paragraphs thoroughly, and all of you start sending me your holidays homework. Okay, in evening you can send me your holidays homework. Okay. Okay, students, thank you and have a nice day. Take care of yourself. And from tomorrow onwards, I'm going to see that you all should have literature books and pencils in your hand. Clear? Okay, students, thank you and have a nice day.